So far in the class, we have been working with JavaScript. Then we looked at jQuery as an add-on. I was going to say a variation, but more an add-on to JavaScript. Then we spent some time with Greensock before moving on to Adobe Animate CC, where we've spent some time most recently. What we're going to look at right now is taking Greensock, which we had looked at in previous weeks, and combining it into Animate CC. And we are going to primarily use Animate to put our elements together, and then we'll actually do the coding or building of the animation through Greensock code that gets added in there. So to get us started, I am on our class site, and I have gone and downloaded the demo files. So there are some starter files here, and then there are just some images that I have provided you with to work from. I've also opened this Tom's Adobe Animate Tip Sheet. I have it open in another tab here, and we're going to use that to pull some base code for Greensock. So if you don't have access to that file, you can always pause and look at the code that we're using and get it from there, from this video. So that is our starting point right now. So I have copied those, or I've downloaded those folders. You can see I've got them in our Project 3 demo folder where we've been working. I created a gsap-animate folder and have put them both there. So there's my Chico images. Here are my starter files right there. So that's my starting point. Now, first of all, I just want to say that adding Greensock coding to Animate CC. Regarding that, Greensock has been used with Flash for quite a while. Of course, Flash has gone away in many aspects. We know that Animate grew out of Flash, and so as Flash was dying off, Greensock was being used less. But in 2012, they ported the Greensock library over to JavaScript. And I did mention earlier that Greensock exists in a Flash version. For those who are still working in that realm, you find it in gaming mostly at this point. But this JavaScript version hasn't been available since 2012 and works very well with the HTML5 canvas animation work that we are doing right now. So once they did that, Greensock started being used more in Animate again. Now, Animate doesn't provide us a real easy way through its interface to load external JavaScript files. So if you recall back when we worked with Greensock, that we have to load the Greensock library or libraries. But there are some custom templates that can help us. And so that's where these starting files come from that I have supplied you with. So there are three different folders, each one having a file in it that I want to point out. So the first one is GSAP Basic. You can find it down here. There's the Animate file. This one is a custom template that loads TweenMax. It is the minified version. And it really just gives us a starting point if we want to work with Animate and have access to Greensock. After that, we get the Add Starter right here. There's the folder. There's the file. Now this one has some additional pieces put in it. So it loads TweenMax and something called Add Helper. There is no code or artwork in this file, and so this is the one that we would use for new banner ad projects. And then the third one is here, GSAP Ad Starter Demo. And this one is based on the Ad Starter file, but it has some artwork in it. So there are assets and an animation there for a GSAP tutorial that they have on their site. So all of these come from the Greensock website and are available there. So first off, I want to get started by opening the Ad Starter demo file. So the one that I have selected here, I'm going to double click and open that one up. Now it's missing a font they've used. I'm just going to let it map to a default font. Okay, so obviously we have some assets. We have some things on our file here. I've got some different images. I've got a button over here. I have their illustration here. And then if I look down here at the bottom, you see that there is really not much in my timeline. Now I have, layers here for all the different pieces, but there's nothing going on in the timeline over here. Also, if I come over and click on these different elements, you can see in the upper right that I have instance names for them. And so that's important for the coding. So you can see as you flip through them that there's a name for each of them. So at this point, I could also go do a command return to test it. And you can see what it did. So you saw the animation as it worked. So you saw the different elements animate into the window. You can also see this button down here is moving. And if you watch it, it's actually going to stop in a moment. There, it stopped just now. So those are the different pieces that they have put in place there. Okay, let's jump back over to Animate real quick. And I'm going to get this output window out of the way. Just shove him over here so we can see our timeline better. Okay. So now, if we look down here in our layers, you can see that there's a JavaScript layer on top. If I click in the first frame, and I go up and get my actions pane, I can see that here is the Greensock code that is running for this one. Let's try and slide this up. I just want to go higher, okay. So here is the Greensock code that is running the animation that we just saw. Anyway, you can see it out there. We don't have to go read it all. But that's what's running it. So instead of it showing in the timeline down here, we have the code here. We've used an actions layer, or action layer here, where we put things in the frames. They're naming theirs JS for JavaScript. So we can see what that is. The other thing we probably want to go look at, I'm going to flip back to my browser. I'm going to view the page source, and let's look through the head section up here. There's meta, there's style sheets that they've put right in place. Okay, as we move down through here, so there's create JS, there is another J, there's the add starter JS file, which we haven't talked about yet, but I told you that they put in place, and right down here, there is TweenMax, okay? So there is the TweenMax JavaScript library that is required for these animations to work. And so that has been put in place already for us. To show you how that gets put in place, let's jump back over to Animate. Look right over here for the Publish Settings over in the Properties. When I click on that, and when I go to Advanced, you'll see right here it says Template for Publishing, and there's a name right there. Okay, it starts with Standard HIDP. So that is the template that it's drawing on. So we're able to use templates that have some base information that is added to our HTML as we publish. In the past, that we would have to publish our file, go manually add it to the HTML, and then we would come back here and tell Animate not to overwrite our HTML, which got a little messy, but the templates work out really well now. If you want to see that template, you can come back out here, and it is in the folder. So see right there, there's the template file that it's using. So you can always go check that out there as well. So it is loading the TweenMax for us. It's also loading AdHelper.js. So some of the things that are specific to AdHelper.js that are specific to our HTML5 banner ads, it pauses and mutes our ad while they're in background tabs, so that's useful. It can set a sleep schedule, so like how that button paused after 15 seconds, which is kind of becoming a standard. So if you've ever looked at a web page and there's an ad sitting off to the side and it just constantly moves, this one pauses after a period of time. It also sets it to wake on interaction. So let me go back over here again. So you see that my button is not moving anymore, but if I put my mouse over it, you see it starts working again, okay? So that is a setting that is coming from Ad Helper as well. So the type of reactions we get there. It also sets it up to display alternate content in older browsers. It can let it have full resolution graphics on high DPI screens. And that's the main thing. The way, let's point out how it does that though with the high-res screens. So notice the size that my ad is showing here. I'll make sure that's at 100% to my browser. But if I go back to Animate, notice that it seems to be much larger. And it is. My stage size over here is set to 600 by 500. But the template is set up to make it half that size. So it's displaying at 300 by 250. So it has double the resolution, which is very helpful when it comes to doing it or displaying it on higher resolution monitors. So it adds all of these features to it. A couple other things it does to it, as it publishes, it adds a 1 pixel black border around the entire ad, and it handles our clicks, so it builds in making the whole ad clickable. By default, it's going to send it to the Greensock.com website, but you can always go back in and change that. So, again, if you want, you can always go back to the template file and take a look at all the code that they have put in place there.